So I have nothing prepared. I was kind of, I asked if I was supposed to give a speech or anything, and I was like, oh, no, you're all set, you know, we're not really going to do the traditional wedding or anything like that.
I was afraid that you were prepared, actually.
That's true. I mean, who knows what would come out. I mean, the less prepared I am, the more much of a fool I make of myself, so. But anyways, I mean, to keep it quick. Were you leaving? You want me to wait? Okay, great. So anyways, while Shane gets a diaper for himself. Alright. So, the first time I met Ryan, or the first time I ever saw him, we didn't know each other, and I'll never forget this. It's really too bad that Shane's gone because it involves Shane too. I was working at Pep Boys, and I was probably just in college, starting college, and they were still in high school because they're really young and I'm old. There's these three idiots that came in at Pep Boys. There's Bob, who's still looking old. That's Pierce here. And then there's Shane. Whatever. And then there's Shane that walks in, and he's probably the normal one out of them all. And then there was Ryan with his pierced ear. I'm here for car parts. You know, looking all tough, like World's Strongest Man competition. I was like, sorry for the kids, but what a bunch of douchebags these guys are. And that was my first impression. So I thought I never would see him again, whatever. They bought their cable stuff, whatever. And so, lo and behold, probably like 3 or 4 years later, we had a mutual friend that I met, and I was home for Thanksgiving from college. We all went out to the movies and met Ryan. Became good friends with a mutual friend, and before I knew it, I became really close with Ryan, and the friendship there just started, and it grew, and it became close to the point where he became a brother to me. And for the people who don't know me so well, I had an older father who passed away a few years ago, and through the whole time I was at home trying to help out with the house. I was trying to, you know, just be there for whatever they needed, and just be there for my dad in the hospital. And the whole time I took him out to lunch or dinner when mom was working, and the whole time Ryan was there. He was helping me get him out of the truck, get him out of the car, you know, whatever he needed, Ryan was there for me. And I never asked for that. He just did it. And it wasn't because he felt bad. It was because he was a friend. And so through the end of it, I learned a lot about myself because of Ryan. Just how to be a friend, how to be a person, and be a good friend. And that's what I have. Ryan's always been there for me whenever I needed it. He's driven up to Bangor when I've had a hard time. He was there. And I mean, I'm happy for him now. I congratulate him. And he's very lucky, because he finally has a woman that can lift more than him. Yeah. He's giving a toast.
Yes, you're making the second one.
Yeah, with the wedding.
So on that note, as I had said earlier, made a little secret video for all of you, because nothing about this wedding, as you can see, Angry Birds, is a traditional wedding. So this is a non-traditional wedding vow that I wanted to share with everybody tonight, and I went about it this way because I'm a very emotional, sappy person, and I didn't want to cry and completely come unglued in front of all of you, so I dodged it and made a video instead. So be prepared to laugh because it is totally tardy, and yeah, that's me. So here we go.
It's not working.
So, surprise, nobody
You Absolutely ridiculous, so bear with us and just